didn't hear earlier, on the Adobe, there are some files on the right-hand side, including the slides for this presentation and instructions for setting up activities in the deck, which will be particularly useful if you are attending a presentation virtual program. If you're on the phone line, please use star 6. So just a little background information on summer reading. Last year, we had over 70,000 people enroll, which is not quite the same as read, but we focus on enrollments, not the actual percentage of people that read after they enroll. And the largest percentage of that goes to the Air Force, which has quite a few libraries, so it's not terribly surprising. Same thing with the Army, they have quite a few libraries. But you can also, since we do have the option of having virtual readers, we could really get the maybe at least to the larger percentage there, I hope, sometime. For reading minutes, not surprising, this is similar to what the enrollment was, but the Air Force also read the most, followed by the Army and then the Marines, and then the Army. And there's a tiny percentage for the virtual program, which we've been holding for the last 3 years, for people that don't live near bases that have their own program. Over time, enrollment had a pretty steady rise. Some years we didn't necessarily get information from installations. We now rely entirely on BeamStack, so if your data is not entered into BeamStack, you won't be counted. That will be helping us in terms of funding. So here's a way to look at it, just as sheer numbers instead of comparing different services. And minutes has also risen. Since we started relying on the logging online instead of by paper, we've seen a very large increase. You can see that difference between 2015 up to 2016. And as we continue to push people to use the online program for logging, it continues to grow. So, basic requirements. In 2020, since we have the situation going on now with COVID-19 and so many libraries are closed, we have changed the rule. Normally, you're required to start no earlier than mid-May and end around Labor Day. But this year, we're allowing for any start-stop date, so you could start now if you want to feed into it with the spring program in the summer. Or you could even have it go that you delay your program entirely and wait until fall or winter to hold the program and use it right to that. Regardless, should be counting minutes and not books. Counting minutes ensures that readers who might be slower are not penalized, and it does hold people like longer books, doesn't penalize them either. It has to be open to all ages, and that includes especially the activities in our local population, especially in terms of funding. And you should be using the DoD summer reading theme, which this year is Dig Deeper, Read, Investigate, Discover. And that includes then using the graphics, the common graphics that everybody should have. And your program should be held for a minimum of 6 years. Your program should be held for, it can be held for much longer than that, of course, especially this year, since you can start now if you wanted to. If you're on the phone line, please And you're required to use BeamStack, as I said, you will be getting all of our data off of BeamStack in terms of reporting. And that, except for this year, because we do have this odd situation, we use BeamStack then for deciding how much money people should get. If you end up needing more supplies, well, right now, you can order more, but they haven't started shipping yet. But if you end up needing more supplies, once the ordering is back on track, you can order directly from the iRage program. Illinois is where our warehouse is located, and they're stuck. So I believe the end of the month will leave, and then they'll have to see if the governor will allow them to return to work in shipping again. Something like a bit over half of the library should have their stuff at least. So our current contract is started in 2019, October, and then we'll have it for 4 years after that. So all of this is going to be true for quite a while. So. Included marketing, including online ads, which is our suggestions. We're not going to have a lot of print depth right now. And more some material then has to be included in each order for options for library, things like staff t-shirts and graphics and such. I'm sorry for hearing an echo. I don't have a fix for that. I can try stopping and restarting my audio. So the contract also includes reading practice. This contract was added in a quality to be considered in the reading practice, so we aren't getting all chief toys. And it's also added in a trophy, so you can have a competition between units or organizations or classes if you have a school running, things like that. And we've also added in supplies so that you can have decorations as well as activity kits for the programs. Can't do direct support for any energy or something like that for a program. It just logistically doesn't work out. So having these kind of programs are closest compromise that we can get. If you have ideas for more supplies or different types of incentives, I'm always open to ideas. But you do have to know, tell us what it had assigned to the IREAD, our contractor, does their planning very early. So already they've already planned for what they have. Are also part of Summer Reading if you're a library program. You should be using your points by the 20th of September at the end of the contract. It sounds like we'll be fine for getting funding for next year. Given our current situation, if it ends up that we're not able to get orders right now, not sending out book orders, and libraries are not able to receive quite a few, libraries not able to receive their orders, you can continue to place orders, but they aren't being shipped. Once they do start shipping, it'll be on who put their order in first, and that will be the first one shipped. So continue to place orders. You might end up getting quite a few books at one point. If it ends up, though, that shipping is delayed and so close to our September 20th cutoff point for this contract, normally we sweep up points. If that happens, we will not sweep up points. But for now, we are planning on sweeping up points that are unused. So I encourage you to keep placing orders, even if you want to really get them shipped. Now, if you want to ensure that any orders you place are not shipped because you're not able to get them, you can contact. I have the contact form on the bottom there. Contact Robert and tell them that you do not want to receive your shipments right now. If you need to place orders, you may well then not ship them, but at least you'll be in the head of the line for getting orders later. If you'd like any changes to your processing, such as having different barcodes or sign labels, you can set up different property profiles, so that you have like YA for the author's name, or you want it to be a certain number of decimal points, you can do a decimal instead of all of that, and you'll have some property profile options. So you can have your sign labels be closer to what you want. Unfortunately, if you're doing a bookstore model, there really isn't any way to handle that, so you might just have them not to have labels on at all if they're still getting labels and they're not useful. And then in general, if you have any issues, you can contact me, you can contact Robert as well. If it's your issue, please copy me that way if you have any issues that we might have that are across the library. If you're on the line, please. So the DoD Virtual Summer Reading Program. Right now we have a summer reading program planned, but we have a spring reading program actually going on. The spring reading program will go through May 16th. As people sign up, they can select what library they have, a home library. Not sure if anyone still has a library, so there's also an MA option. But that will help us with transferring their accounts to your library. They want to transfer. It won't be an automatic thing. The people signing up for this one reading program will have to request to have their account transferred. That way we're protecting your privacy. do it from your end, it would have to be the administrators for the virtual site. In the past, we've had pretty low participation in the virtual summer reading program, so we stopped having it run by the contractor. Does that mean that not everybody who participates will receive a prize? We still plan to go from June 1st to August 31st. When said everyone receiving a prize, I have not received my order either for prizes. So it might end up being gift cards, but we're doing weekly drawings for prizes, and each age group would get for prizes in that. Just how many names I'll draw each week will depend on whether I get the physical prizes and the age of the ship left, or if I end up having to buy new prizes gift cards. Yes, I will share and include the numbers in the goal of all cancellations from the spring reading program. If you're on the military network instead of the commercial network, yes, you won't have the same problem. Commercial is definitely better. I always switch to my commercial computer. So for the spring reading challenge, we're doing $20 Amazon gift cards that are delivered by email. I anticipate that being a strong possibility for the summer reading program as well. You can join the spring reading program since we're running out of the office that's very far different from yours, and there shouldn't be any conflicts there. Winners will be selected randomly, but the leaders must then actually log back to each table to be eligible. So, as we get into program planning, it sounds like this is a very strong possibility we will not be having a normal program anywhere. Because even if we are able to get some libraries in place to work by June or July, whenever you normally start your program, it's very possible that facility restrictions on gatherings and people will not want to go and be with large groups of other people still. So you might consider, as one option, delaying the start of your program until July. Or you could hold a virtual-only program using your own DSAT site. You could do something of a combination, start with a virtual program, start now with a virtual program, and plan for in-person activities to start no later than July. And I also encourage having a fallback date if it doesn't happen to be that you can't do summer at all. Or the last option, you can send people to the DoD virtual summer reading program. As I said, we'll be counting the installation towards your statistics. And you can save your supplies to hold a fall or a winter program instead. So these are the four options I talked about with the other citizen program managers as well. They're fine with them. You don't have to tell me right now which one you're going to do, but I would appreciate knowing as soon as you make a decision and the start and stop dates for your program, just so that you can use it for tracking the statistics a little bit easier, as well as making sure that your DSAT site setup is something that will work. Since occasionally people will miss some changes that can result in people not being able to register or not being able to log or different things like that. Please note that we will not be using the FY20 registrations or minutes or anything else for determining the funding for 21, unless we notice that there's a really high increase in the number of registrations for your location, which indicates you might need more funding for next year. So basically, we aren't holding a zero against anybody. We'll just continue to average the participation from the previous 3 years, and your funding next year will probably be very similar to your funding for this year. So for planning a virtual program, one very key thing, keep it simple. You need to have it down to a message that you can tell people in basically one sentence, because that's about how long your online attention span is. And it makes it very easy for them to be able to start up. So that means as soon as you can, open up your registration. They need that instant gratification, not to be told that they have to come back later and sign up. It's also simpler if you keep all of your programs pretty much exactly the same in terms of how many hours people hold the badge, or you have to do activities in order to earn badges as well, things like that. So just keep your message down to a one sentence explanation. If it's more than that, then it's just too complicated for a virtual program. You also should be including rules. There is an FAQ section that I'll show you later. a good place to put the rules for how they can participate. So that might be, for example, in the spring reading program, I put it in the sponsors act area, sponsor logo area on the login page. But it said things like, you have to have valid email address, and you have to be a valid MWR, customer, things like that. That's sufficient just to be covered on the lead line, especially if you'll be able to have another messaging going out facility that you'll take action to. But at least you'll be covered to the legal perspective then. So you should also have patrons register and log reading on your own. It could be through your BTEC website or the app as well. But if you're relying on your staff to be able to get in and do that for them, it's going to slow the process down, and then you won't be doing this often also. So it's very easy to simple to put them on the top. You should customize your welcome email so that it's a different delivery program. That means going into the setup, the site options, and then there's welcome email. Change it from the default, which basically just says, welcome for joining our program. You can check stuff out online using our service online library. It doesn't really say a whole lot more than that, so customize it to your state and other information you have to keep going on. It would be good to offer more badges. Right now we have the simple setup with 10 badges, but it might be more badges so you give them even longer, especially if you're going to have a whole program that starts now and goes all the way through summer. Or if you just want to get people getting that gratification a little bit faster, it might be 1 hour or something like that. Whatever you think will help them to want to create more. You don't have to necessarily attach a prize to a badge. That's entirely optional. For the spring reading program and for the DoD summer program, there are not prizes for any of the badges because we're going in. But if you're on the phone line, please star me. Star 16. For the summer reading program, for the DoD program, at least there's not prizes attached to anything. But if you do have a prize attached, you will need to go in and make sure that you update how they can get that prize. Whether it's going to be saying that they have to wait until the library opens to call to pick up the prizes, or if they're going to be notified by email or something like that, just put in your prize instructions and help get them if there are prizes attached to the badge. You want to make sure that the prizes are achievable and that the badges are achievable. The default right now is 3 hours for earning up to catch. And that's fairly reasonable, but like I said, you always have more. But if you make it 10 hours to create like that, you're going to be too discouraged. There's not enough that instant gratification going on. You can also, if you're looking for activity ideas or things to encourage people to do at home from your Facebook page or whatever, there is a iRead at home program guide, which tells families how they can make their own summer reading program at their home. I have that in the files on the right hand side, and I also have the URL here. I really encourage you to look at that if you're looking for activities. So, activities. Beanstack includes activity badges, but you don't have to use activity badges if you're not interested. If you have a Facebook page or another way, social media or website to reach your customers, you could also have at-home activities planned that way. So, for example, you could do something like a curbside pickup that includes art projects, and maybe a book that they could borrow or something like that, that they would pick up from either someone at the library, unless they actually stay in the library, or somewhere else if they have another pickup point option or a place that's actually open. You could post activities on your Facebook page or your website, or you could use the announcement email function in Beanstack. So please note that your registrants would have to have turned on opted into those emails to be able to receive them, so not everyone will necessarily receive them if you use the announcement. But you have the option of overriding their opt-out by going into the account creator's report and copying all of the emails there. Make sure that you do use the DCC instead of the 2 if you're doing that, so that email address is safe prior. If you are using Beanstack, you can use the activity badges. In fact, you can set up a whole program that has absolutely no reading and only activities if you're interested. There are a few templates in Beanstack that actually do that. For example, they have a financial literacy program, which is just activities, things like create a budget at home and all these learning program where you just turn on the activity badge instead of the logging badge, or you turn on both if you want to know what's going on in one. Over on the right hand side, I have instructions for how to set up an activity in the file. You can add as many badges as you like, or you can just add a whole bunch of activities to one badge. There are three types of activities. First is the general activity, which just gives either instructions or a link or something like that. The person who goes out and does it and self-validates the way that they completed it. There is an activity code, which they have to enter a code from either a website or that happens in library activities going on eventually. If it's not in a program, something like that, and they answer in the activity code. And there are also text box challenges, which are basically free text boxes. And you have them enter in. For example, your challenge could be that they go and check out a book from Art Digital, and then they would, in the free text box, type in the title of the book that they'd like to prove that they did it. And I also have a link there for how you can get to the OOPS event. So the previous link that I listed was how to get to the iRead guide for the library, which is the one that you got in the mail on the disk. And the link here is for the at-home program guide that I suggest looking at the activity ideas. So planning a virtual program in terms of staff. So you don't necessarily need as many staff involved if it's a purely at-home program, but you do still need your staff to be trained, even if it's just to keep them aware of what's going on. So decide who is going to be responsible for the contact us emails that will come to the Jamstack site. That's part of the setup that you might want to look at changing the site setup options. You also see those emails when you go into people, and one of the options there is the last option on the people page is contact us messages, and you can also see the emails that you get there. Decide who can post to social media. Decide how or if you're going to be handing out physical tracts. And make sure that your staff are trained on how to hand out the files. And decide who will manage any online activities like streaming, story time, virtual book club, etc. Staff training options. Have a staff attach or watch the front desk staff training that will be going on actually later today as well as in the end of the month. I'll be reporting that, sending out the reporting later. So you'll be on the Army Library Programs YouTube page as well. You can record your own training. Don't have access to a virtual meeting application such as Adobe Connect, which we're on right now, you can always use PowerPoint. There's an option to insert a screen capturing, so you can put your training in there, add the notes, etc. My will probably be too large at that point to send an email, so you would need to use then the Army, I mean the DoD file transfer website, which is save.gap.mil, but you would need to be on a non-mil computer. Able to be there. You need to have a credit card logged out. But the person that you send it to does not. Just put in an email address, they pick up a link from the email, and that's it. And you should also be creating a staff program guide. If you want the document version of the staff program guide that we use at our staff training, I can provide you with the doc version, and you can also update that as you use the adjustment program. So outreach is particularly difficult. Not all of you can have access to Facebook pages or other kinds of social media for library programs. A lot of times that's controlled out of your marketing department. So as much as possible, try and get your marketing department to be involved. It works both ways. Only one either the sender or the receiver in your hand card, and if you need on the commercial. I have had issues with personally with trying to see the document. I started trying to find out without a filter network, it said I would be asking the dean for the user. Alright, so again, with the virtual outreach, you need to keep your message very short, down to one sentence. If you can reach your patrons by sending out an email, maybe for everybody that's registered in ILS in person joining the program, that would be a great way to get people's attention that you wouldn't perhaps normally use to get a bit. I know many people don't want to get library emails, but given the situation, it might be important. website and OCAC, and you have the option to make changes to those things. So, being staff, there are two things that you absolutely do have to do to make your program work, and this is whether or not you make a virtual learning program. You need to update your program, VSTEC also calls them challenges, and you also need to update the landing page to change the feature and match up with your program page. You need to make sure that your program status is published instead of draft, and people won't see it to be able to join the program. You need to make sure that in the site options, registration and logging are both enabled. When VSTEC did the setup for this year, we had them make the published status on all programs, but disable being able to register so that people wouldn't be able to register until programs were published. This is because last year there were still quite a few locations that never got their or didn't either programs published in time to be ready for the registration, and then they never noticed that they hadn't gotten their issue there. So the time we're trying to get the registration disabled, we'll see how well that goes. Make sure you've updated that contact email address so it's going to somebody who they're receiving the contact email. And also, big one here, change your password. The default password in VSTEC is something that is a bit of an issue in terms of security, and I will just make you our file and change. While it's very convenient, it's just not a good idea. Also, please note that the registration cannot include age, so that means that your program setup cannot include age. You have to leave it on the default 0 to 109. You can also not include the grade level or other personal information. If you want to have a broad category, you know, say the children are 0 to the age 12 category, and have that be a registration question that someone's going to issue, but it can't be anything that's really identifying the person, like a grade or an age. So, recommended changes. Add prizes to the badges if you have prizes. Add instructions with those prizes for how to pick up the prize, especially this year when the situation is so uncertain. Update the welcome email. Post events, which if you have any events or online activities or anything going on, make sure that they're posted there so you can maximize your outreach. Add some custom activities. The default template does include activities. Most of the things are have to do with the digital library. And include weekly announcements and emails to keep the readers engaged. Reading tends to drop off when one gets past the first month of program, but if you keep readers engaged, hopefully you can contact the website and log in over here for activities. So even more stuff that you can do to have a really robust virtual program. Set up, or regular program, which you also can see. Set up a prize drawing. Have a follow-up survey again so you can see how people liked it. Customize your dashboard, so when you go into the dashboard, it already has your program selected, and you can really get all the data that you need. Create a book list to match the program page. Customize the FAQ page, which not so many people will look at, but just in case they do at the moment, the default page is all about VSTEC, and mostly focuses on VSTEC recommended book list, which it's a feature that I think most of us probably aren't really using that much since our own programs. Add more badges. It doesn't necessarily have to be a requirement to complete the program. Those badges, you can always change the program completion setup so that they only have to earn, say, 5 or 10 badges, even if you post 100 badges. You don't have to change how many badges are required for completion, but you can always add in more badges so that those really avid readers continue to see goals to be. And join the VSTEC or Zuki rather email distro list. You contact Zuki and they'll add you to that. They have a lot of really great system updates as well as training plans and program ideas. For instance, there's another town hall meeting going to be held in the VSTEC Facebook group at the end of the month. Talk about virtual summer reading and ask questions and things like that. And there is the Beanstack app. The Beanstack research shows that if people are going into the app, they tend to log more than if they're online on their own. There's a convenient timer for being able to count reading time, and they can also just scan an ISBN if they want to log in. There's no plan right now for a staff side app, but the app is here wherever you are around the world, in your applicants. Today there'll be another training at 1300 for Funko's staff training. Or after the Q&A training, so you don't have to come tonight if you are not interested. You can call again at 1800. And the next front desk staff training will be repeated in on the 23rd as well. And then video training is on Army Library Program YouTube page. I put the link in for the parents, and I have sent that out before and then send it out again. So reminders, when you do get your supplies, if you have not already told me, please tell me. If there's anything that's broken or missing, etc., once you've inventoried it, we can get it replaced, but it won't be right now because they're not currently shipping. Hopefully in May. Also, please tell me when you decide on your program format, which was 4 months, and your start and end date. If you have a fall or winter program that you're going to be planning to attend to your supplies, just tell me as well, so I get a general idea of when to start looking for your participants. Again, don't add age or grades to the GSAT program registration. Check that your GSAT program is in published status and that your login is turned on so people can start signing up with the register. And if you're viewing photos, because you are able to actually have any perspective you can, please make sure that they are by right resolution. And if they're using any photos that have people in them, either have the back of their head or anybody in the photo would have to have a photo of the file. We like using those photos for presentations that you give to the DoD and the service branch leadership, as well as use for our annual report. Are there any questions? No, I wowed everybody. I'll turn on the microphone for everybody in case you don't want to type it in. So I guess nobody has any questions. If you have questions later, you can always email me. I hope you'll come to one of the front desk trainings. Yeah, thank you very much.